So Midjourney Alpha is here finally. So you don't have to use the Discord if you have access. Luckily, I have access to it right now, and I'll show you the difference between Midjourney on Discord and Midjourney on their own app in Alpha. So many new features, so many new things. We're gonna get into it. I'm gonna compare both, and I'll show you everything, kind of a fast tutorial. I've only played around with it for a few hours, so hopefully I know some of this. We're gonna learn together in this video. So let's get into the Midjourney app or Midjourney website, and I'll show you the difference. All right, so here we are on midjourney.com. You can see /explore. Now, if you're gonna need a Midjourney account, which I do have, and you can see it's Midjourney Alpha right now. So that's recently changed. And what you used to do, this kind of looks similar to what it was before, where you have, you know, the top rated and the, we have it up here, hot, daily, likes and all of those. If you go through that, that still works. That's still up here. But what's different is this. Right here, you can actually do a prompt from the home screen. So you can see it says imagine. You don't have to do the /imagine anymore. So when you were in Discord, you'd have to go in here. This is the Discord one. You have to go imagine and do all that. Well, now in here, it already does it for you. It knows, just like all the other ones, you know, like Leonardo and ChatGPT, you don't actually have to do that. The prompt, the /imagine. Midjourney is getting rid of that as well in here for their alpha at least. And then here are some filters here. So you can do portrait, square, landscape. So you don't actually have to type those in the prompt. And then you can do your styles from 0 to 1,000, weirdness 0 to 3,000, variety 0 to 100, and you can reset it back to 0. So those are here, the aesthetics. You also don't have to type those in your prompt, and the model. So you can do a raw or standard, or you can do what version you want to use. It's defaulted at the latest version, which is 6, but you can go all the way back and do some of these, as well as the Niji ones, which is really cool. It's all in here, so you don't have to put that at the end or do that before you do it. And then speed, if you've used Midjourney, you know this. You could do a relaxed speed, a fast speed, or a turbo speed. So I'm gonna click off of that. That's to open and close it, this filter icon. And then it says right here, hover for more information. So it says, welcome to the Midjourney Alpha. Creation is in alpha and being tested with experienced users like yourself who have made more than 100 images. I've made more than 100. And we'll make an announcement when it's available to everyone. So not everyone can get this, but I'm showing you a sneak peek for those that don't have this. And then you can randomize this thing on the homepage. So let's do that. Boom. It keeps randomizing stuff. And you can still come on here and click on these. And what that will do is it will open up and you can see all the different things about it, the aspect ratio, the prompt. You can like it, you can do all those things. I think there's more down here too. You can use this as something. So you can use it as an image, you can use it as the style, you can use the prompt, so it does it right away. So if you like this, when you hit prompt right there, it adds it to it. And it uses all the references that they've used too in here. You can also say, I wanna use this style or image. You can see both style and image. And when you're ready, all those things, you're just gonna hit enter and it will do it for you. But I'm not gonna do that one right now. We'll try something else. So I can close off of that. I'll just hit that. Let's see, what else? Oh yeah, we got so many things. So you can search the prompts too. So if you're looking for something, let's say we're doing something for like a corgi, it's gonna search all of it, whatever anybody has done for corgis, you can do. And so if you're looking for a specific style, it's really cool because, you know, there's so many different styles. You can do this nice cool cartoony one, or this vector one, or if you wanna do that kind of stuff. And so you can use these as a base for your style, which is really cool. We're gonna click that off. And then let's see, create. You can also create here, but if you hit create, it'll show you the ones that you just created in order. So you can see I've worked on some shrimp designs, and it'll tell you right here. And you can also use these as well. So this is kind of like your personal feed of what you just did. And then archive, this is everything. So just quick pictures, and then you can filter these things too, which is really cool. So these are all the things you can see. I've made more than 100 designs. And then rooms, I actually haven't tried this yet, but I guess you can go in here and try the different rooms and see what people are creating in those rooms to get some inspiration and stuff. And you can come in here and still rate images, like which ones do you like better. That kind of helps, and rate ideas. So if you submit an idea, you can do that and to help Midjourney. And news, so I'm guessing rooms are open to the One Click Club. I don't know what this means, but this is the latest news if you want to keep up on news and announcements and so on. Let's see, help down here, just going down the side. If you need help there, report bugging, light mode, and then your profile. All right, so let's try and create something. Let's do, like we always do, a corgi eating ramen. Let's see what Midjourney 6 does. I'm just gonna leave it at that and see if it does a cartoon style or whatever. And again, we can come in here and we can stylize it. So we're gonna do square. Let's do just mid 500. Weirdness, why not? Let's just do all of them mid and variety. So we're gonna get a good variety of different corgis eating ramen. Standard's fine, version 6, yes, fast. And once you're done with that, I'm gonna hit enter and you can see it's submitted. And if you go to create, you can see it's doing one, and there you go. So you see chaos is the one. This is just like the ones if you would type in into Midjourney and Discord, the chaos, the style, and the weirdness with those numbers. And we'll come back to show you what it looks like when it's done. All right, so it took a little while, but here we go. These are the ones that came up. Let's look at it. Not exactly what I wanted, but we can change that. Let's take a look. So very different styles. I didn't give it any prompts on what kind of style. So it went for, you know, more realistic, and for this one, more realistic. I actually want a cartoon one, which I probably should have put in there. So let's go back and show you like all the different things this does. So again, it shows 4 just like it does in the Discord. But here are some other things you can do with it. So you can hide it, you can do more. Let me show you what's in more. You got copy, report, download. So when you download it, I'm gonna download it here. I'll show you what that does. And it's gonna put it in a square, like 4 square, like you showed, like you see on Discord. So let me pull that up real quick. So this is what it does when you download it, just the 4 square, kinda like I said in Discord. Now there's some other things you can do on here. So I'm gonna just click on one. Let's do this one. And you'll notice I'm gonna move myself here instead. These are some of the things you could do on Discord as well. So you can vary, right? That was the V123. We already know which one it is, so we don't have to put that, click that button. So we can vary. And this will give us 4 other ones, right? Either a subtle one or a strong variation. You can also upscale just like you did in Discord. A subtle upscale or a creative upscale. I'm not really sure what that means. So I'm gonna hit creative upscale and see what happens. Did I hit it once already? Oh, there we go. It's gonna do a creative upscale, whatever that means. And then remix, you can remix this with something subtle or strong. And then you can pan just like you do on those in Discord. And then the zoom, you got that. And you got to change the aspect ratio as well. So it doesn't have to be a square, it can be a different size. You can rerun it, right? Like you did in Discord, that that button, I believe it's this one right here on Discord. That's rerun. And let's see, vary region. I haven't done that, that's pretty cool. So we got some new stuff in here. And then you can use this image or style or prompt again if you wanna do it. So you can put it in here so you see something. So you can do that with anything. So when we search for these, so let's say we wanna try a different one. Oh, it's ready. Let's see the creative upscale. Well, that's interesting. So it changed it from that to this, just I guess it gave it more, kind of blurred the background and made this more crisp. Yeah, that's a pretty good, oops, that's a pretty good upscale. So we got that. Yeah, that's interesting. So it kind of changed the background a little bit and made the front come up. So that's really cool. All right, so well, let's do explore and do explore for corgi ramen, see if anybody else has made it. So you can see here now I can go and find a style that I like. Maybe it's this style right here, and I can use this as the style as well as a prompt. So we can change this prompt. So I changed the prompt. Instead, it says a simple corgi cartoon in a white transparent background eating ramen. Great. And I'm going to make sure that we have that style as well. So we get that and use the image. So we're going to use that image and the style, and we're going to do change that. And let's see what this comes up with. So this is closer to what I want. The style is the one I want, and the white background. And you can see it's doing it right here. This was the upscale that I did. So everything that you did is in line here. You can kind of scroll through it and you can see what I did. Oh, and we did the chaos style weird. I probably should have took that off with the filters. I can do it again and run it again and see without the filter. So let's do this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click here. You can see it's already finishing up. I'm gonna hit use and I'm gonna take away this chaos thing. I'm gonna take it down so that it's the same. Maybe that will work. I'm gonna take all of that out. We still got the image and the style, and we're gonna hit that again. And let's see what that comes up with. So we got this one that has chaos style and weird, and this one that doesn't. And let's see how much different that is just for a test. But to see right here, the white background, I love this one. That's pretty cool. I don't know why it says DGAP. We could take that out. Let's see some of the other ones. This one's a cute one. That's pretty cool. So because we had those, the chaos style and weird, you can see it's so different from the original, and hopefully the other one is not as different. Yeah, this one's really different because of this right here. So let's go back and see what it did. Yeah, so this is more matching what we had in the original one. Still don't like this one though. G-O-D. Oh, I wonder if it's trying to spell dog, but it did it backwards. Yeah, this is a nice one, but it doesn't look like ramen. This is interesting. Sours. Anyway, it's still an alpha. We're still learning. We're still gonna have to do some of these things. But you can see the difference between one that has chaos style and weird on it and one that doesn't, where they're a lot more similar here. If you want something, then try something really different. If you want to go back in here and try some of these other things, you can do that as well. So that's basically it. That's all of it. I think if I missed anything, let me know in the comments. But it's fun. I think this is a nice new way to do it. I think there's still lots to learn, but there's so many features now at your fingertips, especially with this right here. And then as you go into one, you can do even more with that, with these down here, like all of those. So lots to play with. I'm going to learn how to use it better. And I think what's really cool is that it's all in one, where I used to have to go back and forth from Discord and then come in here and then look at my images in the Explorer and the archive. Now I can do it all in here without the slash imagine, and it just works great. So hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you. I know we're still in alpha, which is before beta, so it's not even in beta yet. So they're still working out the kinks and working out how everything works, but I right now, I think it's really cool that you can do some of these things and search and try out different things. So there you go. There's Midjourney Alpha. We played around with it a little bit. Hopefully that was really helpful for you. If you have access, try it out. See if you go midjourney.com and see if you have access. If you've been using Midjourney and you pay for it, you probably have access if you've done more than 100 designs like I have. Let me know what you think. In the comments, if you've played around with it, or if this is your first thing on Midjourney, let me know in the comments what you thought of this whole thing, this upgrade, this alpha. If you're interested in AI art, I have a whole playlist of AI art right here. I'll put it right here, and you can deep dive into some of the other things like Leonardo and Ideogram and ChatGPT. I've used all of those for print on demand, so you can watch any of those videos to get more information. Thanks again for watching, and as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.